Danny Morrow here, continuing discussion the source of Allah, the word Allah. We have to look at astral religions. And again, I repeat, these things that I'm reading about Islam and explaining about Islam, the word Allah, the Quran, and so forth, these are not my writings. And these writings are not patented. But these are writings that have been written by scholars and archaeologists with PhDs from various universities in the world. Astral religions. In Arabia, the sun god was viewed as a female goddess and the moon as the male god. As has been pointed out by many scholars such as Alfred Gilliumi, the moon god was called by various names, one of which was Allah. The name Allah was used as the personal name of the moon god, in addition to other titles that could be given to him. Allah, the moon god, was married to the sun goddess. Together they produced three goddesses, who were called the daughters of Allah. These three goddesses were, and I'm going to spell this, A-L-L-A-T, A-L-U-Z-Z-A, and M-A-N-A-T. I'm going to try to pronounce that. The first one is Al-Lat, and then Al-Usa, and then Manat. The daughters of Allah, along with Allah and the sun goddess, were viewed as high gods. That is, they were viewed as being at the top of the pantheon of Arabian deities. Along with Allah, however, they worshipped a host of lesser gods and daughters of Allah. That's A-L-L-A. The crescent moon symbol. The symbol of the worship of the moon god in Arabian culture and elsewhere throughout the Middle East was the crescent moon. Archaeologists have dug up numerous statues and hieroglyphic inscriptions in which a crescent moon was seated on top of the head of the deity to symbolize the worship of the moon god, in the same fashion as the sun is pictured above the Egyptian deity. While the moon was generally worshipped as a female deity in the ancient Near East, the Arabs viewed it as a male deity. The gods of the Quraysh tribe into which Muhammad was born, was particularly devoted to Allah, the moon god, and especially to Allah's three daughters, who were viewed as intercessors between the people and Allah. The worship of the three goddesses, Al-Lat, Al-Usa, and Manat, played a significant role in the worship at the Kaaba in Mecca. The first two daughters of Allah had names which were feminine forms of Allah. The literal Arabic name of Muhammad's father was Abd-Allah, Abd Allah. His uncle's name was Obied-Allah. These names reveal the personal devotion that Muhammad's pagan family had to the worship of Allah, the moon god. This is very significant information. I sincerely hope that if you're a Muslim and you've read these articles that I've done on YouTube on the Quran, on Allah, and on Islam, that you would consider what is being told you here. These are facts of history, facts of the Arab world before Muhammad, who was without a doubt a false prophet.